First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the room based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intentions straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
All right, we're going to be dealing with tonight zombies, drugs, and the occult. Now, we know that there is no such thing officially as we could say a zombie. That means someone who has been resurrected from the dead or who has been killed or murdered or whatever the case may be, whether it's through a virus or et cetera, who have been actually deadened by that virus and then resurrected or brought back to life by that particular virus. Normally, that's what we see within the zombie movies. There will be some type of outbreak in which that occurs, in which that caused that to occur. We'll get into some information in which that shows that, you know, basically that eating of flesh has been around for quite some time. There's an article in the from BBC News, SciTech, in which that states that the Neanderthals were cannibals. Now, amazingly, that when they check the genes of Africans, the Neanderthal gene is not there. It's not there. As a matter of fact, this is what the article says. Excavation at the cave of the Mula in Gorasi, yielded 78 Neanderthal bones from at least six individuals who lived 100,000 years ago. Remnants of two adults, two 15 or 16-year-olds, and two 6 or 7-year-olds were dug up, as well as nearly 400 pieces of animal bones. Careful study of the tooth marks and fractions of the remains shows that these Neanderthals were master butchers. All right, then it goes down. There was no signs of charred either, suggesting the flesh was either eaten raw, or cooked off the bone. It is not clear whether the individuals were eaten for survival when other food was scarce or part of a social ritual. There has been hints of Neanderthal cannibalism at other sites before this. Is by far the clearest evidence in the first in Europe. no sign of gnawing was found on the bones. Ruled out the possibility that the Neanderthals were eaten by wild animals. So they were eating each other. As a matter of fact, yeah, many cases of that occurring. But before we get back to that, let's get into Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. You know, there was also The Island of Dr. Moreau. These particular movies and books put all of this in mind also. All right? And why we're saying this is because when you read certain amounts of information, like, for example, for those who study the Kabbalah, the Sefer Yetzirah, this is perhaps the most important work of the Moorish Hebrews or mystics. And tradition holds that the book was written by the patriarch or Abraham. Of course, you know, that's a biblical character as allegory. However, it says that the use of these methods is found in the text to create a golem. Right now, a golem or mankind, which is a kind of man. Now, a golem is also symbolic to a Frankenstein creature that we now refer to it as, or a zombie. All right? Similar methods. Now, this is what it says. It says the golem can be created using many different methods, according to the sources. Some state that it is accomplished through combination of letters. These letters, of course, are referring to the genes of DNA. You know, the various sequences, the sequences of the codes. As a matter of fact, there's 64 permutations of DNA. All right? And only 20 plus 2 stop codons, so 22 are actually accessible or used. The other 42 are non-coding or non-active. And from these combinations, you actually can tap into designing or making a golem, which would be actually a slave. That's what a zombie is. A zombie was used by the mystics or the magi as a slave. You know, they do his bidding, do their bidding. So these combinations are called gates. And the number of gates differs according to the various Kabbalistic schools and ranging numbers from 231 to as many as 271, depending upon how the letters, which is amino acid sequences, are to be combined. Now, other schools taught that a golem was created through the utterance of the divine names. So, of course, you know, we have 12 of the major divine names of Yahuwah, Yahweh. Now, the Talmud records that there are 12, 42, and even 72 letters names of God, or Yahweh. All right, many schools, such as the Hasidim, all right, these Hasidim, these are the Jews, which that is oftentimes in the Brooklyn, Queens, New York area, New Jersey area, etc. And they held that the Hebrew word idmet, all right, idmet, which means truth, all right, was used. Now, the word idmet is very reminiscent to me as mayat, because it's spelled E-M-E-T. And of course, mayat is spelled M-A-A-T. All right, so, and it means truth. Mayat means truth. So, the Hebrew word, this word truth, which is imat, what happened is that it was inscribed upon the forehead of the golem. Right? And amongst the number of methods of deconstructing a golem, a common one was the erasure of the aleph, which is life, the first letter of admit, or imat. This leaves the word mat, which means dead, which destroys the golem. Okay, so this is, according to Halberstam, from the Shalom Kabbalistic text. So, this is how it was made by the mystics. Now, we know that in such places as within Haiti, in different other places. Yeah, some of the same things in which that went on. All right. For example, we had, if you watch the movie, what's the name of the movie? The movie Surfing in the Rainbow. That's it. Surfing in the Rainbow. You watch the movie Surfing in the Rainbow. It speaks about Haiti and how they took the ingredients from the puffer fish. It's called Tetragonidae. In which that could put a person into a zombie-like state. Right? Matter of fact, when the United States Pharmaceutical Company went to Haiti to get the samples and tests, this is what the movie was actually showing too, just happened for real in the 80s. Now, that was in the 80s. Now, you can imagine what they could have synthesized since then, all right? And my homegirl Avery, she brought that to my attention too. Now, in Japan, there's a fish called the fuku fish, which can be cooked by trained chefs, or you would die if some delicatessen, you know what I'm saying? So animals have been used also in a way in order to make these zombies. Now, of course, they're telling us that these zombies are occurring because of bath salts, in which that'll crush and looks like cocaine and it's sniffed, or whatever the case may be. And this is causing the people to go crazy. Now, we have some questions about that. There's some questions about that for real. All right. How do I sound now, y'all? I'm using Skype, so this is probably the reason why for the muffled sound. It's clear, but just sound cloudy. All right. How do it sound now? Okay, y'all can still hear me. All right. So, what we found out is that there's some other shit that's going on, besides for the bath salts, besides for the possibilities of the way in which the Haitians do it. What we found out that there was a virus that was made by the Miami Institute by scientists, and which that somehow got out and now is airborne. However, those with O blood type are not infected. All right, now this is actual article. All right. Now, it's called zombie virus, possible via rabies-flu hybrid. This is what it says now. Check this shit out. All right, and basically it says highly improbable genetic tweak could create mutant virus. Now, this is from the National Geographic, actually October 27th, 2010. Now, that's interesting because for those who have actually seen my video from back in the days, The War of the Worlds, Part 1, I show how the National Geographic article came out July of the year before the Katrina disaster, talking about the levees breaking. Okay? Now, this is interesting. Here it is again. This is October 27, 2010. And this is what the article says. Indie zombie flicks such as 28 Days and later I Am Legend, an unstoppable viral plague sweeps across humanity, transforming people into mindless monsters with cannibalistic tendencies. Though dead humans can't be brought back to life, certain viruses can induce such aggression and zombie-like behavior. Scientists say in this new National Geographical Channel documentary, The Truth Behind Zombies, premiering Saturday at 10 p.m. So as you see, they already had this going. And this was out actually for the last nearly 2 years. All right? So it says, for instance, rabies, a viral disease that affects the central nervous system, can drive people to become violently mad, according to Andrew Ansky, a virologist at the University of Miami Miller School of Medicine in Florida, who also appears in the documentary. So you see, Miami keep coming up over and over again. Combine rabies with the ability of a flu virus to spread quickly through the air, and you might have the making of a zombie apocalypse. Rabies virus a mutation possible, unlike movie zombies, which becomes reanimated almost immediately after the infections. The first sign a human has rabies, such as anxiety, confusion, paralysis, hallucinations, so don't typically appear for 10 days to a year, and the virus incubates inside the body. Now, I got something for that. Potassium iodine. That's the cure to all of this already off the bat. When we come with solutions, we come with the science. Potassium iodine. Once the rabies set in, though, it's fatal within a week. It's left untreated. If the genetic codes of the rabies virus experience enough changes or mutations, the incubation time could be reduced dramatically, scientists say. Many viruses have naturally high mutation rates and constantly change as a means of evading and bypassing the defense of their hosts. There are various ways viral mutations can occur, for example, through copying mistakes during a gene replication or during the ultraviolet light. Now, rabies can mutate fast enough. It could cause infection within an hour or a few hours, and that's entirely possible, Andrzejewski say. Now, this is the one that's interesting. They go to the airborne rabies, which create rage virus. But for the rage virus to trigger a zombie pandemic, like in the movies, it would also have to be much more contagious. Humans typically catch rabies after being bitten by an infested dog or animal, and the infection usually stops there. All right? So a faster mode of transmission would be through the air, which is how the influenza virus spreads. Now remember, rabies and flu combined. So all rabies has to do is go airborne, and it has the rage virus like 28 days. Now this is from Max Mogg, head of the Zombie Research Society, said in the documentary. The international nonprofit is devoted to raising the levels of zombie scholarship in the arts and science, according to their website. So there are actual societies that teach on this. To be transmitted in air, rabies would have to be ball traits from another virus, such as influenza. Different forms and strands of the same virus could sweep pieces of genetic codes through process called reassortment or recombination, said Sabia, a biologist at the Virginia Tech, who was not involved in the documentary. All right? So, they go on to say, engineering zombie virus possible is theoretically possible, though extremely difficult to combine a hybrid rabies influenza virus using modern genetic engineering techniques from the University of Miami, Andrzejewski. Say, sure, I can imagine a scenario where you mix rabies with a flu virus to get airborne transmission. It needs a virus to get personality changes. all right? An encephalitis virus to cook your brain with fever and thus increase aggression even further, and throw in the Ebola virus to cause you to bleed from your guts. Combine all these and you get something like a zombie virus, she says. Okay? Now, check this out. There's an article. Another one's called Florida, the Real Naked Zombies Attack. Cover up zombie virus now called excited delirium. All right. Now, this is interesting because we got a report on that, and we're going to play the report. And we're going to come back and build on this information a little bit further here. But here's the report.
Hi, everybody. Today is May 28, 2012. I'm sure you guys have heard by now about the zombie attack there in Miami. Evidently, the poor man that was attacked had 80% of his face literally ripped off. Before the police officers shot this so-called zombie several times, when the police officer asked him to stop, he just looked at the police officer and growled at him. And it took multiple shots before they were able to kill him. I imagine it was probably a headshot. But they're saying that it was drug-induced. And they actually have a link here to a website called Excited Delirium. There's evidently been multiple cases in Miami that has not been reported about this zombie behavior. They even have a research document page for police officers. This is from the University of Miami. Excited Delirium. You can't make this stuff up. Over the past decade, increased attention has been paid to the sudden and seemingly unexpected deaths in some highly agitated subjects being held in police custody. In most of these cases, force required to restrain or incapacitate the subject has not been sufficient to cause death, and yet they died. Symptoms of excited delirium include bizarre and/or aggressive behavior, shouting, paranoia, panic, violence towards others, unexpected physical strength, and hyperthermia. This is where they suddenly feel overheated and start ripping off their own clothes. And it says here, throughout the United States and Canada, these cases are frequently associated with drug abuse. But tests have shown that it hasn't been drug abuse. They think there's an underlying central nervous system disorder was the precipitant cause of death in these people. Goes on to say, fact, ED as they call it, is a medical emergency that presents itself to law enforcement as a law enforcement problem. ED is not easily recognized. ED containment require backup personnel. ED victims exhibit superhuman strength, are imperious to pain. Restraint positions and use of electronic control devices, taser, to override the CNS. And it says ED is a life-threatening emergency. Here it says inside their bodies, their organs are burning up. They reach temperatures where they actually are burning up and actually makes them take off their clothes. So this is why a lot of these so-called zombies are naked. So I did some research and I found three cases in Florida. One where a man was tasered and there's a lawsuit. The most recent one, where they ripped off the poor guy's face. This here, you might want to pause this to read this if you can. Enlarge it. This is where the fellow had to be tasered and he died. This one here is where a woman attacked a man in his motorized wheelchair. He said that she claimed during the attack that she was a vampire and was going to eat him. She was later found half naked and she had no recollection of the attack. But then there was another interesting one in Colorado. This fellow evidently was at the Denver Zoo with his girlfriend. All of a sudden, he just started bringing up and started taking off his clothes and put his head underwater, started acting very bizarre, attacking people. It took five people to get him under control. And they accused him of being on drugs, too, and it was found out he was not on drugs. She thought possibly he was having a heat stroke. And this is why he started the zombie behavior attacking and biting people. In Denver, Colorado, too, there was another one where a woman walked into a convenience store and just started attacking people and biting them. Then there was a case in California where a 49-year-old woman just started going crazy and bit to death a 47-year-old friend more than a dozen times. And they said that something happened. She went crazy. Phoenix, Arizona. A man walks into a Target store and starts gnawing on some woman's foot. And then got another one here. El Paso, Texas. Man was found dead of apparently, they think it was mauled by dogs, but yet no dogs were ever found. So I was thinking, you know, you could always say, and this was in a city, El Paso, Texas, you can always blame wild dogs on zombie attacks. Right there, the dog or dogs have not been found. Another case where a naked man lunged at police, biting one in the leg. I mean, and then I don't know if you can read that, but yeah. He says he picked up a woman and flung her around like she was a rag doll. The police were able to stop the assault. I believe this is also in Texas where a couple were walking and they were attacked by a naked woman. Says if you don't think, oh, excuse me, this was the one where they were driving down the street and she was waving her arms in the air and they thought she was the victim, but she turned out to be the zombie. So then there's other parts of the world. Oh, I didn't do that one. A woman walking alone early Thursday morning was attacked from behind by a group of six other women she did not know, according to the police. After the attack, which police categorized as unusual, they identified what victim took herself to the medical center with a 2-inch laceration and across one of her legs and bite marks on her back. There was also a case, I believe this is the one that was in China, where a 6-year-old boy's penis was bitten off by his father. Evidently, they were walking down the street when this happened. Here's another one. Oh, is this Dubai? Because I know there was a case in Dubai. Yeah, Dubai. Man was sentenced to 2.5 years in prison and ordered his deportation from the UAE after he was convicted of robbing an Asian nurse and biting off parts of her face. The unidentified man also convicted of resisting arrest and biting the hands of two police officers when they caught him. So he got sentenced for 1 year for attacking the nurse. And here's one more that I found. If I can get it to pop up. After some confusion, which police unit should handle the case, theft and robbery, they haven't found anything missing. A 75-year-old woman was allegedly mauled to death inside her house. She'd had no pets. Results of the autopsies, who found the dead woman in her bedroom and showed that she was killed. She was mauled to death, but nothing was missing. She was just torn into shreds. So like I said, this ED is on the rise in Miami. They're not reporting it. We'll just have to keep looking. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye now.
There was an article according to National Geographic that came out October the 27th, 2010, in which that spoke about zombie virus, possible virus rabies, dash flu hybrid. Now, that's interesting because according to another report, a virus was made by the Miami Institute from the scientists there, and somehow that got out and now is airborne. But they state that those with O blood type are not infested. Now, that means that whatever this was that was released, this virus, dealt with particular blood types, if this article have any bearing. Now, when we get to this article within the National Geographic, it speaks about the fact of this hybrid of rabies and flu vaccine being combined. flu virus, I should say, being combined. And that's interesting, you know, that this article was written 2 years ago. And just like I made mention of within my video from about maybe 7 years ago, we did what was called War of the Worlds, in which that we spoke about particular viruses in which that could be combined, in which that could be put forth airborne. And the influenza, or the Spanish influenza, was part of this list in which that we said that could be utilized in order to do so. And how over 75 to over 100, if you go to Stephen Quayle's website, you will find over 100 scientists have been killed. And we've been trying to figure out why would they be killed. You know, this has been even reported on Coast to Coast, that over 100 scientists have been killed. So you can go to www.stephenquayle.com. Or stevequayle.com, and you can actually look on there and find out all the biologists, chemists, you know, that deals with these types of sciences, viruses, bacteria, parasites, all right? But why would these particular scientists be killed? What do they have planned? Well, National Geographic is stating what they have planned. And matter of fact, the article goes on to say that in the zombie-like flick, or the zombie flick of 28 days later in I Am Legend, an unstoppable viral plague swept across humanity, transforming people into mindless monsters with cannibalistic tendencies. You know, that's from National Geographic. You know, that's what they compared it to, what could possibly happen. Matter of fact, it says, for instance, rabies. Now, why would they use rabies? Well, it says a viral disease that infects the central nervous system can drive people to become violently mad, according to Samantha Andreski, a biologist at the University of Miami. Now, Miami keep popping up over and over again. This is where this supposed airborne virus would have been released from, was Miami Institute. You know, here, you know, University of Miami, Miller School of Medicine in Florida, this biologist is shown on the documentary speaking about this combination of the rabies and plus, you know, to make it airborne, a flu virus. And I don't think this is no coincidence. And then, of course, the first major one that they speak about, the first case in which that occurred the first week of June, or the first major case with that last week of May, first week of June area that week, was the Miami. At least that's the one that they documented, the one that they broadcast on the news as the first one. Instead, they referred to it as the zombie apocalypse, in a sense, or refer to them as being zombies. You know, however, it says, unlike the movie zombies, which became reanimated almost immediately after infection, the first sign a human has rabies, such as anxiety, confusion, paralysis, hypnosis, hallucinations, don't typically appear for 10 days to a year as the virus incubates inside the body. Now, we may mention of the fact of if there's any possible, if there's a problem, but there's also a solution. The solution actually would be potassium iodine, in which that destroys viruses and bacteria within the body. So it says, once rabies sets in, though it's fatal within a week if left untreated, if the genetic code of the rabies virus experiences enough changes, While mutation is incubation time can be reduced dramatically, scientists say. Many viruses have naturally high mutation rates and constantly change as a means of evading or bypassing the defense of their hosts. The various ways of viral mutations can occur, for example, through copying mistakes during gene replication or damage from ultraviolet light. All right. Now, we know that in our case, melanated people, ultraviolet light destroys bacteria and viruses. The more vitamin D that you are able to absorb through your skin, because vitamin D actually is a hormone, it's not just a vitamin. And when you look at the word vitamin and minerals, the major word or suffix or prefix within that those particular words is min, M-I-N, in which that min is another form of amen, which means the hidden substance or hidden force or power, which in this case, men is also the fertility deity. So it's talking about the links to the sexual nature, which is linked to your longevity upon this planet. The more you're able to conserve your sexual energy and recirculate it through the microcosmic and macrocosmic orbit technique, the more it regenerates you and the more your life force expands and basically you gain longevity, even to the point of immortality. All right? So this is what this article is dealing with. And it says, it goes on, it says, all rabies have to do is go airborne and you have the rage virus, like in 28 days later. Max Mogg, head of the Zombie Research Society, saying the documentary. All right? So they actually have a zombie research society. You know, that means there's enough validity throughout history in order to verify that something is going on or has gone on upon this planet dealing with zombie or zombie-like tendencies. All right? Also dealing with cannibalism, as we also see. All right? There's another article in which that we went through. Hopefully y'all heard the broadcast. Y'all know if y'all did or not. Let me go to... All right, did y'all hear the broadcast in which that was stated? I want to make sure that. Okay, thank you. Now, when we talk about these cases, we talk about that first one in Miami, in which that was by an individual by the name of Rudy Eugene, in which that he ate off 80% of the face of a homeless man by the name of Ronald Popo. Now, that was the first case. The second case was dealing with a porn star, all right, Loca Roca Magnota, all right, who is now on the run. You know, and he dismembered Jun Lin, who was a Chinese student, you know, and mailed his body parts to political officials in Canada. All right, matter of fact, they just found another part of him not too long ago, just days ago, according to the news reports. All right, so there's definitely things going on. Now, you got some more cases here in which that deals with these types of things. Let's go on, because it's bigger than bath salts. There's another article in which that speaks about how they've been trying to blame The police are blaming it on synthetic drugs called bath salts. People are taking this as a joke, but this is quite serious because we show you that the shit is happening all over the world, you know, that there's something definitely going on. And you can say through mind control, but the mind control means that there has to be some type of trigger. But what is triggering this? You know, why is someone in Thailand, a British citizen in Thailand, walking around with, three fetuses, roasted fetuses, human fetuses? You know, what is going on here? You know, we got another report that's come down. And the crazy thing is that this is happening. And you know, we can keep, you know, there's actually more than, there's actually like cannibals in the news. Like, there's five bizarre acts of human flesh eating in just 1 week. Right, this is according to the article, June 2nd, 2012. Right. And that, of course, was Alexander Kino, who admitted to killing his own roommate, as we made mention of a little bit earlier, then eating the heart and the brain. All right. And then, when a single act of cannibalism is reported, you know, it's unfathomable, or unsettling, as it is unsettling, to have five incidences to dominate the news cycle, you know, within a week seems almost unprecedented. So this is the reason why I put them saying an apocalypse, because, you know, we haven't gotten to that yet. But all but one of the following cases are alleged crimes. They range from international manhunt from a suspect accused of chopping up and eating his male partner. This is who we just finished talking about. Loka, all right. Rocco, Magneta, right. To a chef who served and who severed and served his own testicles, right. This is one. We spoke about him, but there's another one here of an international manhunt for a suspect accused of chopping up and eating his male partner. All right, that's who that was. To a chef who severed and served his own testicles. Now, we heard another report of another man who was having out with the police, and he stabs himself, and he throws out pieces of his entrails, of his intestines, at the police. This is crazy shit that's going on, you know. Right, then we have now the one who did that, Mayo Sejiyama, right? I guess he called himself a self-described asexual from Tokyo. He's the one who got surgery to remove his genitals, then cooked and served them to five dinner guests at a slinky banquet in Japan. Okay. That's who that guy's name was. All right, now that is a Hackensack man, you know, who was in critical condition after allegedly stabbing himself and throwing his intestines at the police. That's what we just talked about. This happened on May 29th. All this was happening within a week's time, the end of May, beginning of June. You know. Now, if y'all remember, that was around the time when we started seeing that big, the big moon coming in. So, hence, this is the time of with that moon, that large moon, Then, of course, the moon is symbolic to Luna, hence for the word lunatic. All right? So we can add that astrological influence into that scenario also, because this is around that same time period. You know? And we know that the moon influences the waters of the body, as well as the waters of the oceans, of the earth. The earth is 75% water. Your physical body is 75% water. We know that every 28 days it changes phases of the moon. Well, within the woman's body is every 28 days in which her menstrual cycle comes on. So, I mean, these things are apparent, and these are scientific. All right, this is no coincidence that during the time period, police know that they don't have more problems during a full moon, especially in this particular case with the big moon, as they called it. What was the other name of it? Was it saying about the big moon? It was in Venus. So Venus deals with love, but also Venus can also deal with madness if you don't know how to gauge those energies properly. Because love can turn, there's a thin line between love and hate, as they say. And so these things also occur because of those astrological influences. All right? So, all right, and matter of fact, the guy who stabbed himself and thrown his intestines at the officers was named Wayne Carter. Wayne Carter. Okay. Now, you know, some of your favorite rapper is named Wayne Carter. You know, that's something that's interesting also. Now, what do the CDC or the Center of Disease Control say? They say not to worry despite strange strains of incidents. This is what they say about it. Don't worry. Be happy. What they say. All right. If the news has you worried lately that a zombie apocalypse may soon be underway, don't panic. According to the United States Center for Disease Control and Prevention, you're not likely to find your dad walking around knowing that you're flush. Well, shit, you already got motherfuckers doing it already. CDC does not know of a virus or condition that will reanimate the dead. Exactly. Or one that will present zombie-like symptoms, according to David Daggett, said in an email to the Huffington Post today. Yes, you read that right. The federal agency aims to protect the United States from a disease outbreak has officially weighed in on the possibility of actual zombies. The comment comes after a string of strange incidences involving seemingly non-human behavior over the last week. In Miami, a naked man was shot. Of course, we already went over all of those. So, this is what they had to say about it. All right? You know what I'm saying? So, we're going to go to the phone lines and let's see what questions we had. 314, you're on the line. 314, you're on the line.
Islam Moore, Brother Vinnell from the same.
Brother L, how you doing today?
I'm doing fine, sir. How you doing?
All right, you're doing well.
I was Vinnell, yes, sir. I was listening to your story. I did hear the lady speak about the different viruses, especially in the Miami area. And I heard you speak about this one Chinese father had bit off his son's penis. I was thinking about it. I believe that a lot of they're telling you that a lot of this stuff is going on through movies, like
yeah.
The movies The Crazies. I saw
yeah.
And another movie with Will Smith. I forgot the name of that movie with Will Smith.
I Am Legend.
That's what it was. That's what it
mm-hmm.
was. I Am Legend. Yes, sir. And another movie was set in England, touching on the same thing.
Right, and then you got the TV show now, TV series that's real popular called The Walking Dead.
Yes, that one. That one, especially that one. They have a series of those. And it's amazing, you know. I had my doubts, you know, that this stuff is actually going on. But now, after hearing the lady speak about it, that you have played, the tape you have played about this lady, has spoke about it now, I believe this is actually going on.
Oh, yeah. Well, there's a lot of this going on. I mean, this has been going on for the ages. The elite been eating and drinking blood, you know, doing these blood sacrifices. I mean, this is what's going on now. This is a real big thing that's been exposed within the industry. And actually, they doing more help to it by hyping it, because the curiosity of it all is what is probably projecting out and causing the individuals, you know, who, you know, are into this type of thing, you know, to act out, you know, and to actually start beginning to practice, you know, what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and sometimes, that's reverse psychology. You know, you tell a child no, you know what I'm saying, they're going to say yes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, I mean, this is just what's going on. And so, we know that they've been doing this throughout the ages. This is nothing new, you know, as far as human sacrifices. I mean, the Bible has it with Abraham getting ready to sacrifice his son Isaac to God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, getting ready to sacrifice to Yahweh.
Yes,
yes,
sir. Mm-hmm. And I know it's a lot of, I learned a lot about this too, about the most powerful people, and influential people on the planet. You know, politicians dealing with political activities, even from the White House, the Pentagon, and other countries as well that's participating in some of these rituals.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Like,
actually, this takes place also at the Bohemian Grove.
Uh-huh.
You know, where they worship a 50-foot tall owl in California, which that deals with human sacrifice. You know, or effigy. So, I mean, there's a lot of things going on. You know, we just have to become aware of it, you know. And, you know, I know that Dr. York said some years ago, he prophesied within a book called Leviathan 666,
mm-hmm.
that he was dealing with that topic, in which he said that there would come a time when men would be eating men, you know, when people would be eating people.
I believe that's part of the reason why they have him locked up right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I believe that is. I also heard about the 100 scientists you said that were murdered. I heard
right.
about that. Yes, I heard
right.
about that.
Right. So why would 100 scientists, right? So this is my question to anyone who thinks that this is just conspiracy theory. 100 people dying is not no fucking theory. That's a fact.
Mm-hmm.
And they are all scientists. You know, so I don't care what you believe. You give me a reason for why 100 top scientists in the world will have to be murdered.
And you know, that's not even...
Or die under mysterious circumstances. If anyone
mm-hmm.
give me any answer to that, please try to give it to me. Because I know that they're dealing with biology. And they're dealing with viruses and bacteria. You know what I'm saying? And they're dealing with parasites, you know, in which most of these doctors were. They was biologists. They was biologists. They were dealing with bacteria. They were dealing with all of these types of things. So, you know, why would 100 top scientists have to be killed if something isn't getting ready to take place, or they're not working on something, or something isn't already going on?
Mm-hmm. I doubt that even we've seen any news, did it?
No, it didn't.
I didn't think so. I know it don't meet the local. I know it
don't
meet the local stations.
Right, I've been talking about it for over the last 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the time when I started talking about it, it was only 50. It was over 50 at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's over 100.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why I care about it because I have a friend who's a scientist.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And she dealt with viruses and bacteria and all those types of things too.
Because I know
mm-hmm.
I know that Monsanto is into that also.
Exactly, and that's controlled by the Rockefellers.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir. The right. brother was
and
telling
to be part of, right, to be part of eugenics.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No, the brother was telling me about it. He worked there at Beaumont Santos, and he was as a janitor, and he was telling me he working toward this area where they had experimentations at, and he saw a dog with six legs and another dog with an ear on his back, a human ear on his back. You know, it was real bizarre what he was telling me.
Right.
And he no longer works there now. As he said, they fired him.
Of course.
You know, he said he's seen too much. He said that they fired him because he thought they fired him because he saw too much. They
right.
had to let him
well,
go.
They'd be glad today.
If they didn't kill him.
Yeah, exactly.
No, because it was bizarre. You know, I've seen, like I was telling you before about the movies, that they're trying to tell you through the movies that these things are actually going on. Like you say, the Dawn of the Dead,
right.
on the Crazies.
Right. The
and,
Living Dead. Right.
And I Am Legend. And, because I know Will Smith, in the movie, he was an Army officer, Army medical officer.
Right.
And he was trying to, I don't know what he was trying, if I can remember right, he was trying to prevent this disease or something.
Right.
But at the beginning of the movie, they had this lady, she was on the news. And she was lying her butt off. You're talking about, oh, no, the virus is not, very harmless, you know. And then he was saying, lying, no, because she's lying, you know. Next thing you know, the whole world was infected.
Right.
Where he was at. You know, the only one left was him and his German Shepherd dog.
That's right.
So, I'm like, wow. Because it affected his dog. I think the dog got bit by one of the zombies, and he had to put him to sleep. And then some kind of way they found out where he was at. And it was a little bizarre movie. I got to see that again.
Yeah, that was one of the most popular movies a few years ago, so I'm pretty sure everybody's familiar with it. Hold on, brother. L, you might bring someone else in. I'm going to have a discussion on it. Area code 111, you're on the line.
Yes, sir.
Area code 111, someone calling in private, you're on the line.
Hello.
Yes, greetings.
Oh, good night, Dr. Bay. This is Deborah Wellington. Hi, how are you?
Oh, peace. How you doing?
I'm great. We're thankful that you're still on the air and you're still doing your show. It's very informative, as always. I just spoke with your wife, and she confirmed that for June 27th, we're supposed to do an interview with this young lady named Ms. Tracy Piper, and she has a wellness center within New York City. She performs colonic irrigations at her spa, her wellness center.
Oh, right. Well, that sounds good. You're going to need it.
Excuse me?
I said you're going to need it. You're going to need as much cleansing out as possible.
Exactly. So I just wanted to, if I may, just introduce Ms. Tracy Piper, her center real quickly, if I may.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much. Choose the Piper Center for all your internal wellness needs. Health begins in the colon. How many bowel movements have you had today? If not three, it's time to cleanse. It's the Piper Center in New York City at 73 Spring Street, Suite 304 at 1212-925-0203, info@thepipercenter.com. Thank you so much, and have a great night.
All right, you too. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Now, that's going to be June 27th, 2012. That's going to be within the next 2 weeks, Wednesday here, 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Make sure y'all are here. We're going to get into the science of healing, colonics, fasting, herbs, so forth and so on, vitamins, minerals. You're going to definitely need to be here after hearing this show here tonight. All right. Brother L, you here?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Only thing I'm saying is that there's definitely something going on. We have to be, you know, we have to look at the coincidences, as they would say. Actually, there's no such thing as coincidence. If we go beyond two things, then it's not a coincidence because co means two. These are too many things in which that is taking place in which that fits into this piece of a puzzle. And those over 100 scientists definitely fits into that scenario.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. I also took down your, you say about potassium iodine.
Right.
Yes, sir. I took that down. Where can I get that? Do you know, I get that at a health food store or?
You can order it through us. Yeah, you can order it through us or either get online.
Okay, I'll order through you. Okay, brother.
Mm-hmm. You get it from us. It's a liquid in which that comes in a droplet form in which that you can take 5 to 10 drops, put it in within your water. It strengthens your thyroid gland in which that destroys bacteria and viruses in the body
mm-hmm.
because it strengthens your immune system and your lymphatic system.
Yes, because I'm already taking you what you advised me to take, like the cayenne and the golden seal already combined.
Right.
And but I, like I said, the 1 week off and 3 weeks on, that was the advice you gave me.
Right.
So I'm on that already.
All right. That's good.
So
and everybody needs to have a blood cleanser daily. You need blood cleansers, whether it's burdock, yellow dock, chaparral, golden seal, you know, chickweed. You need blood cleansers on a daily basis.
Yes, sir.
Red clover, you need them.
Yes, sir. I noticed I have like a burning sensation. Like first when I eat, I usually do it when I eat something. I like to eat something with it, you know, and take
mm-hmm.
plenty of fluids. And
right.
it has something, but it doesn't burn like it was when I first started, though.
Right.
It's like a burning sensation, and I guess that's merely burning some of the way the antioxidants that's in my body and my system.
Right.
I don't know. I even had. The bowel movements more frequently now since I take it. You know, I can even, like I said, like when I urinate, I can even smell it when my urine. So I remember you telling me that was a good sign.
Right, exactly.
It's but yeah, back to the zombies. I believe a lot of those are the corporate government's experimentations, and that's one of the probably projects to downsize the human population.
Right. Well, Jimmy Carter signed into order what is called the Global Report 2000, in which that they wanted 2.7 billion non-white people eliminated from the face of the planet, preferably by famine, drugs, disease, and war. But that didn't happen fast enough for them, so now they are doing the slow things in which that can occur. So they're doing it through the food, through the water, the drinks, so forth and so on, you know, through the environment, you know, just through everything that they can actually, you know, basically, you know, design. And the thing is that we just have to keep ourselves strong, you know, being able to ward off, you know, those particular problems, you know, viruses, bacteria, whatever the case may be, you know, and antioxidants, taking a lot of antioxidants only to attack the free radicals within the body, you know, just a lot, you know, that we need to start doing. And I'm saying it in a way in which that, you know, is like, you know, a battle, but I mean, really it's not once you, you know, master it, but in the beginning when you're just learning and trying to figure out, you know, what to do, then, yeah, it is. It's a hard battle, you know, trying to master this thing called life and this physical body, this temple of God.
Okay.
You know, but there's certain keys in which that goes along with it, so you just have to figure out what your key is, because everybody has a different key, you know, which that unlocks the mysteries, you know, the signs of this body.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Okay. Because I know we were talking about the chemtrails about a couple of weeks ago, and they are trying to put a lot of airborne viruses that way, you know,
right.
Dropping them from planes and things
right.
like, you know, it really is monstrous.
Exactly.
It shows that we are under a structure of monsters. They call
right.
themselves scientists and doctors, you know.
Mm-hmm. So, exactly. So, why would they be killing off their own? Because, obviously, there are a faction within their own establishment in which that would not go along with what they have set up for humanity.
So, that's why you have a lot of these murders of all these different scientists.
Right.
And, you know, certain police officers are really fighting against that as well. I've heard
right.
military personnel and the like.
Yep.
And I was two that I know that like I said they all in your corporate government. Some of the richest and influential people of the world are also offered to that. You know, funding whatever money they can to see that this thing really succeeds. You know, and I'm like, wow. You know,
right. See, me personally, I don't have a problem with the definition of eugenics. I have a problem with who's behind it, based on the white supremacy, and based on the attitude, the racial superiority attitude of those who are pushing it.
Mm-hmm. But I see a lot of their own people being wasted, being killed. I know
yeah.
he was telling me about gamma rays. I said, "What is a gamma ray?" And then we were riding down the highway. He said, "There's one right there," and this big pole that had kind of thick at the top, but he said what it does is sends out certain frequencies and vibrations, and probably a lot of people in that area wound up having cancer.
Right.
I'm like, wow. You know. He said, yeah. You know. But he said he was surprised to see it in a Albion community. And I said, really, I'm not surprised. You know. But he was in the Albion community where we saw this at.
Right.
And I said, man, they're getting rid of their own people.
Oh, yeah.
Because, I mean, they are,
oh, yeah.
A lot of them think that they're in and they're not in.
Right.
But, you were saying, back to the, you saying that the, a lot of these so-called white supremacists, you know, is behind a lot of that, those monstrous acts that they're committing against the people.
Right, exactly.
And I think they spend.
Now, I'm not into, you know, not into big like so-called reptilian thing, but even the president, you know, Obama had to admit that there's people who work at the reptilian portion of their brain,
uh-huh.
in which that, you know. A person who is relegated to the dominancy of, you know, of the reptilian portion of the brain, they have so much fear. It's fight or flight all the time with them. They're very competitive. They are usually the psychopath or what we call the sociopath. I don't like psycho because the word psycho means dealing with the soul, psyche. It's not the mind, it's the soul. And they don't have a soul. So they're sociopaths. people who have this reptilian portion of the brain and they don't work at the neocortex or the frontal lobe area of the brain, they can't feel what you feel. They can't. They do not have the emotional body that you have.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have imitation. They can imitate, you know what's going on. But they themselves don't have genuine feelings.
No kind of emotions or nothing.
Right, and this is what's going on with these cannibals or zombies, whatever the case is. As we read within the articles, most of them don't have any sorrow whatsoever. So the reptilian portion, the people are being relegated to the reptilian portion of the brain so that these things can take place and make society the way that that is going in the direction of, in which that is for their benefit, which is chaos. So they believe that from out of chaos comes order.
Right. Right. You know, I was at the Masonic Grand Hall, Grand Lodge yesterday, and we had what we call a charity meeting. And another Moor, he was talking to me, and he said, "Look at all those past grandmasters and potentates and all that. You know," he said, "pretty soon this economy is going to fold." And they think they really got something. You know, I'm trying to get off the subject, but they think they really got something. But when it really fold and they realize that they don't have no gold or silver to back them up, they're going to be with the, standing there with their eyes wide open and their mouth poked out and shocked. And I said, "Yeah, true." And then they had this program, they're pushing this program about these chips. They call them kid chips, or what they call them, to put on children in case they get lost. And I was trying to tell a few of them, but I said, "I don't like that." And they said, "What's wrong with it?" They said, "They can put a chip in you where they can tell where your whereabouts at all times." You know, but a lot of these European Masons came to the Prince Hall Masonic Grand Lodge and were trying to push it. And a lot of the brothers went right along with it, you know.
Hmm.
I'm
That's
like,
interesting,
wow.
That's interesting.
It is interesting. Yes, it is. You know, because, they say it's on they already experimented on dogs already.
Right.
But now they want to experiment with children. So on the pretext that, you know, that in case your child get lost or kidnapped or whatever, we can find them right away.
Right.
But that, to me, that ain't nothing but a cover-up.
It is, because, they're making so much money right now off the black market of, taking kids on sacrifices, blood sacrifices, was also putting them in sex slave rings.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? These children, they're not really trying to protect these children, because they still going to have a high sex ring population of children, as well as also doing these sacrifices. So, that's just, like you said, a ploy on which that they are using, and those who are 33 degrees and, they know this, why would they even go along with microchips? What's the effects of the microchips? What if the microchips begin to leak, and the radiation from these chips begin to leak within the body?
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of consequences to these particular actions.
Right, right. So they looking at it as a positive thing.
Right.
That's what they're looking at it as. But I see it far beyond that.
Right, we're going to tell them to take that Bible from off the altar, because according to the book of Revelation, the 13th chapter, it speaks about the mark of the beast.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? In which that, it says that, the mark will be put within the right hand or within the forehead. In which that, of course, those who have read scripture, and those who will first become aware of the microchip, they have already correlated that to the microchip. I mean, you can watch any of the movies in which that they have out on the in a day, you know, in which they show this is being part of that scenario, part of that interpretation of that particular passage. You know, not saying that it necessarily is, but it has validity based on the fact that they are pushing this thing, you know, so hard, you know, and they've been trying to pass it now for the last, you know, 15, you know, years or so, you know. And if people keep resisting, and we need to keep resisting.
Good.
We need to resist vaccinations. We need to resist, you know, the chemtrails. We need to resist the heart. We need to resist, you know, the microchip. We need to resist all of these things. You know, otherwise we will not have any liberties. The little bit of liberties that we do have, we will not have any.
You won't.
I mean, that would be over. And then the elite, you know, said, Rothschilds and Rockefellers, they've just controlled everything. You know, it's bad enough that they already control over 51% of the resources on the planet.
Right. I was looking at not the CNN, but it was another station I was looking at, and they had about the banking industry, and they especially were talking about the J.P. Morgan trade losses. And most of the people don't know that the J.P. Morgans ain't nothing but a front for the House of Rothschild.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And another thing, too, is that I knew a brother. His name is Brian Wong. And Phil Valentine actually interviewed him years ago. He went to prison.
Did he?
Yeah, he came out of prison. And, of course, he was hearing voices and all these types of things that was going on. Phil Valentine took him to the hospital, took him to the doctor, and the doctor examined him and found all these microchips in him.
Huh.
All right? And the doctor said, look, I have a family, and whoever put those there intended for them to stay there. So guess what happened? Them damn chips stayed in his ass.
Huh.
So one of the things in which that they used was argon energy, magnets, iodine, diodes, crystals. These are certain things, especially with copper, you know what I'm saying, or frequencies to interfere. So, I mean, there's a lot of things. Internally, the herbs in which that was used was these blood cleansing herbs, as we made mention of, in particular, chlorella and spirulina in order to deal with any radiation leak from them. Some say getting x-rays or microwave, you know what I'm saying? You can actually utilize, I mean, there's a lot of things that people have spoken about, you know what I'm saying, about ways in order to deal with this, you know, but, I mean, it is even said that many of us has already been chipped for years now, you know, for at least the last 20 years, you know, children probably have been chipped already, because I know that Brian Wong, I know this thing here was about 15, 20 years ago when that took place. Well, hell, you know, so, I mean, it's already been going on, you know, but it hasn't been going on a mass scale. And that's what they want to take it to. They want it to become acceptable, you know. And so they have to use the violation of your children because you love you love the kids, you know. And so that's what they want to use it as a pretext for, you know. But like you said, that's what it is a pretext, you know. It's nothing more.
I knew my hunters was right when they first came up with that. You know, nothing like, maybe some of this stuff about the Masonic Order is true. I said, well, maybe it is true. I said, when they can't, that's the first thing since I've been in the Order, since I heard something like that, you know. Of course, I voted against it.
Right. Well, I mean, that's the most common sense thing to do. I mean, and plus, I mean, you have a 6,000-degree at the base of the spine energy in which that can raise up and burn out those types of things also. It's called the kundalini energy, serpentine fire. And
okay.
as it reaches the top of the head, actually the energy can permeate in a golden disk. It's up to 2 million degrees. You know, so, I mean, we are very special. And so we can actually destroy these things and dissolve them, you know, through our own body energies. If you learn the science of Qigong and Tai Chi and Reiki and different other pranic healings, you know, and begin to start practicing things on a daily basis,
mm-hmm.
You know, that's one thing is that, you know, this is still the temple of God, you know,
mm-hmm.
and regardless on, you know, what they do, you know, we can do something else.
Right.
Know, because the scriptures also speaks about the fact that there will come a time where men will be able to eat poison or drink poison and will not harm us. If we get bit by poisonous snakes, and we will not die. You know what I'm saying? That's in the book of Mark. You know, so, I mean, there come a time when we'll be able to have these particular gifts. And these same gifts are mentioned within 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter.
Mm-hmm.
The gifts of healing, the gifts of miracles, the gifts of faith and knowledge, wisdom, you know,
okay.
understanding, you know, discernment of spirits, you know, speaking in tongues, you know, diversity, interpretation of tongues. You know, all these gifts, you know, you would get, you know, it's called the nine fruits of Christ. So
mm-hmm.
when you come back to your Christhood or your Heruhood, you know, you can come back into your Godhood, as they would say, your kingdom, you know, then, you know, you develop all these particular gifts. This
mm-hmm.
is nothing more than like chemistry, clairvoyance, clairaudience, clairgestance, clairsentience, you know, all these particular things, the gift of levitation, telepathics, you know, mentalism.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we learn all these particular things, you know. So it's just about, you know, us working with ourselves and mastering ourselves, and then we don't even have to worry about what's going on. You know, they know the movies that they have, you know, will become play, you know, such as the movies like Chronicles and different other movies that's coming out showing us receiving these particular gifts. But they always
okay.
have something outside of us in which they help give it to us. But really what's going to be it is not is the energies from outside. So it's not going to be like, per se, a meteorite, you know, like they showed in the Chronicles, but it's going to be something that comes from the sky, which is the sun itself. That goes back to Malachi, the third chapter, which speaks about a day will come where the earth will burn like an oven. You know,
right.
those who are evil will be, burnt asunder, basically. You know what I'm saying? They were burnt to their roots. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, for those, you know, who abide by the law, you know, it would be like receiving healing in his wings.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think that's what that's Malachi, the fourth chapter, the second verse, in which that speaks on that. So, I mean, you know, when we get to those types of levels, you know what I'm saying, understanding the way that the sun, the earth, our bodies are interacting, the place, with those particular sciences, then we can begin to start manifesting the highest heights.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was thinking of Malachi Zoka L. Somebody told me that he's not never getting out of the prison, you know, because of the things he knows about them, the things that the topics we're talking about tonight. And, I was somebody told me the actor Wesley Snipes was a student of his, and I don't know, you know.
Yeah, he was a student of Dr. Malachi Zoka. He was actually a former Father Center.
I didn't even know. I didn't know that.
He also from the same school, I think, it was the White Lotus from out of Brooklyn, New York, in which that Queen Afua and all of them was actually part of, which was the Egyptian Order,
uh-huh.
in which that. I think, yeah, they was from out of Brooklyn. So, you know, you have, he was part of that also. But I think it was the thought, school of Ptah, you know what I'm saying? You know, so, yeah, he definitely wanted information, you know. And I know he definitely was a student of Dr. Malachi of New York.
Uh-huh. I don't forget. People keep on asking me, is he out of jail? I said, I don't know.
No, not yet.
I don't know if
but he will be, right, but he will be sometime here soon, because it has been almost that long.
I think they were the reason why he's in jail for a lot of things he's into. You know, and I believe, you know, it says about taxes, which I'm surprised he had a lawyer, though, to fight his case.
Right.
Did. Like I said, I keep watching these movies dealing with zombies and the governmental, always call it corporate governmental experimentations on the populace. And that's all it's about. Dealing with behavior patterns, and they know what particular part of the brain where they can kind of push buttons on where you can act a certain way, especially in a negative way.
Right. Well, that's what we're talking about. I mean, everything was that dealing with, remember tonight's show was called Zombies, Drugs, Mind Control. All right, so we are into the mind control area right now. And these are the things in which that happens, you know, based on the particular events in which that is taking place in society right now. Of course, you know, some might think that it's irrelevant, but we put keys together here in which that is trying to tie all these pieces together, because this is a puzzle in order to figure out exactly what's the next move, because it's just like a chessboard game. You know what I'm saying? You can figure out the move. You know, things can come, you know, your opponent three moves ahead. But if you, you're just nothing more than a pawn, you know what I'm saying, in the game, and you don't really know what's really going on, then, you know, your pawns get taken every time, as they say. So, you know, we're trying to definitely, you know, put all these pieces together. And it's very relevant as far as I'm concerned, because, there's very few shows that talks about this information. Most shows, from what I see here on Blog Talk Radio, or entertainment shows, you know, nothing in which that give people, you know, much thought. It's nothing more than usually just like with TV, it's entertainment. But that's why, you know, we came here into this market ourselves in order to give more relevant information, in order to help uplift for humanity, because I know that's my mission and my job per se. And I know that for those in which that are listening, you know, obviously that's your jobs also. So, I mean, this is what we do, you know, each one teach one, so that we can take it out and take this information and spread it out to, you know, to the masses,
right.
You know, in particular from our families and then friends, associates, and then out, you know, to others, as they say, 6 degrees of separation. So we will touch someone, you know, who is famous, you know, and that has happened. You know, I've had entertainers to hit me up who have actually watched my DVDs, you know, members of Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Right.
You know, members of Wu-Tang Clan, you know. This is just phenomenal. You know, the way that this information spreads. So we can't take it lightly, because we're touching the masses, we're touching the world.
Most definitely. Yes. Like I say, mind control through television, radio, music. You know, even in your magazines, they send out subliminal messages, you know, to the mind. And I just learned about when you look at television through one's home, especially at nighttime, you may walk past or drive past a person's home and you see how dark it is in their rooms, and you see the TV flickering. I mean, man, it's flickering. I mean, it's just flickering. And I just now learned that that's a part of mind control as well. You know, training the brain to have an attention span only for 60 seconds.
Right.
Wow.
Right. And also, let me state this, is that I use the scriptures only in the sense of verifying certain things in which that allegedly has been prophesied, in which that when you're trying to tap into a Christian mentality, you have to use what they know, you know, and some of the people are coming from out of that mentality and they're coming into hearing things about the Illuminati, but they don't know the occult secrets and symbolism. So when they come into these particular schools and then they just see the Illuminati, Masons, you know, oh, that's evil, just everything is evil. You know what I'm saying? But yet not understanding the symbolism. And then you have to realize that when you're talking about symbolism, the symbolism always has a lion message behind it, in which that deals actually with the human body. You know, what's the point of having a symbol? I mean, it's like you trying to, you know, feed me the symbol of Christ on the back of the of a Christian car. That's a symbol. I can't eat that. Nothing I can do with that.
Right.
You know, now go give me a real fish, then I can do something with it.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So, I mean, you know, there's something beyond, you know, the symbolism. And this is the only thing that was said the majority of these people who teach, you know, about the Illuminati, you know, teaches. You know what I'm saying? For example, you know, Jordan Maxwell, Alex Jones, all of them teach nothing more than the symbolism.
Okay.
So people get caught up into the symbolism and think that they are decoding something, you know, mystical. And they haven't decoded anything, actually.
Okay.
They did astrology. They did astrology or astrotheology, you know, but they had nothing to do with physiology and
okay.
biology.
Okay.
So that's the real application of any knowledge is how it applies to you.
Okay. No,
you
I
know,
think
so.
I don't think mm-hmm. Jordan Maxwell or Alex Jones ever get into that.
No, they don't. And that's what I'm saying is that people who get caught up into their information, David Icke also, you know, who get caught up into their information don't realize the physiology in dealing with the human body.
Mm.
You know, that all the scriptures actually are relating back to. You know,
mm.
that's actually the real symbolism of the scriptures is talking about is actually the human body.
Okay. Okay.
No, I mean that's the ultimate end of all so-called holy inspired scriptures.
Okay.
And their message in which that is only relevant to you. You know, like I tell people all the time, Moses split the Red Sea 4,000 years ago. What is that going to do for me now?
Right.
No, it has no symbolism. I mean, it has a symbolism, but it has no relevance to me whatsoever.
Okay.
Now when I start breaking down that my heart splits the Red Sea, which is my blood supply in my body, and my heart splits the Red Sea because it pumps. I got four chambers of my heart, you know,
okay.
You know, two ventricles and two arteries, you know, and they split the blood to and fro, pump the blood to and fro, you know, then I understand what they're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
That has some relevance to me, you know, when I read this story. Now I understand the symbolism. But I'm just thinking, but if I'm just reading about Moses got sealed in the basket of slime, got sealed up the river, you know, and saw the royal house, and the empress, you know, or the you know, the princess picked him up and raised her as his own, and her own for 40 years in the Pharaoh's house, you know, what do they got to do with me?
Right.
Until you realize that the slime, you know, in the basket, in the sealed up that you were sealed in, is all talking about the sperm and the egg.
Okay. The sperm and the egg. Yeah, I was thinking about this other movie I saw about a couple of years ago called The Last Airbender. And I noticed the young boy, every time he tried to control the water, he always had to go to a female. To get advice and let them train. He mastered it, but he always had to go to a female. And I wonder was the feminine aspect and the water connected? That's what they're trying to tell you through the movie.
What?
You know, I don't know if you saw the movie or not.
Oh yeah, I did.
Oh okay. Well, what did you get out of that movie, y'all?
The master himself, to become the avatar, he had to control the four elements, earth, air, water, and fire, in which that's what our physical body is composed of, is earth, air, water, and fire.
Okay.
You know, the fire is our body at a 98.6 degree constant constant. You know, our bodies being 75% water. You know, our breath, in which that we inhale and exhale, 4 cubic feet. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I got out of it, too.
Right. And as well as also, and our earth, which is 25% apparent solid material. You know, so, you know, these are the things in which that I got out of it was once he mastered his physical body, hence, with the combination of all four of those elements, you gain ether, which is the mind over matter principle, and that's what happened. He had to master his mind.
Okay, he had to master, okay.
Right, he had to master his mind. But we get ready to go. Thank you, brother. L, for coming in.
Okay,
and,
brother.
Helping me co-host this show tonight. Appreciate you.
Oh, no problem, brother, at all.
All right.
And I will send for that potassium iodide. I will send off for that.
All right, brother. And to everybody else.
First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air. No doubt. All right. There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance.
Order.
System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages for us to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories.